हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू शॉर्ट हैंड सुपर फास्ट राइटर्स। दोस्तों, आप चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन को दबाएं डेली शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस के लिए। आज की डिक्टेशन वॉल्यूम नंबर 8 से ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 163। बी रेडी, 10 सेकेंड्स, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट। सर, द हाउस विल रिमेंबर दैट ओवर द पास्ट फ्यू ईयर्स दैट वी हैव बीन हियर, वी हैव बीन डिमांडिंग अ चेंज इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ आवर टैक्सेशन, एंड इट इज ओनली दिस ईयर वी हैव हर्ड द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर अनाउंस दैट द टाइम हैज कम व्हेन द टैक्स स्ट्रक्चर of our country must be changed. What exactly is the change in the tax structure that is going to be made still remains to be seen. Only the other day, on the 3rd November in Kolkata, Mr. Pant, chairman of the Finance Commission, was stating that the financial stability of the state and the central governments, as well as the successful implementation of the 11th five-year plan, depended to a large extent on a radical change of outlook of the people towards taxation. In that speech, he also made it clear that he would expect the common people to pay more taxes. Now, if the change of structure of the taxation system is to be sought in order to continue to exact the limited savings of the common man, deprive him of the necessities of life, then I would not be in favor of any such change. If, however, the tax structure were to be changed for a policy that would make the rich pay for the 11th five-year plan, I would be in favor of it. I may make it clear that it has never been the contention of the people that they would not bear the responsibility of building up the country. In fact, our workers in the factories are sweating day in and day out so that our industrial production goes up. If today we claim higher industrial output, it is precisely because our men in the wheels of industry have so behaved themselves and have so worked for the well-being of the country that despite the mechanization and intrigues of the capitalist class, despite their greed for more and more profits, it has been possible to bring about a sizable increase in the industrial output. The credit entirely belongs to the working people of our country. Similarly, if in the agrarian sector of our economy the production of food has gone up simultaneously, raising thereby the total national income, that is also because of the fact that the peasants, however poor, however destitute, and however suffering, have responded to the call of the government. It is only because of their devotion to duty for the cause of the country that we are today in a position to claim before the whole world that our agricultural production has gone up. I say this because we must remember that it is the people who are playing with their blood, paying with their sweat for the rebuilding of our country's economy, for the rejuvenation of our nation. Our capitalist friends, who regard themselves as the captains of industry and have produced more shipwrecks than happy sailings, would please note this particular fact, that it is these men, working people, whether in the agricultural sector or the industrial sector, who are responsible for the rise in production, and therefore it is they who have brought about an increase in the national income, from which they have been denied their legitimate share. Mr. Deputy Chairman, now we are discussing the question of taxes. The Finance Minister is in a very chastened mood these days. I think that he is in a very happy posture of mind today when he makes such speeches. He forgets that merely by taking money from the rich, you don't distribute to the poor. We have seen in the United States, in Germany, in England, where heavy taxation measures obtain at the same time, relatively speaking, the poverty of the people continues. Sometimes it so happens that the ruling class, the capitalist class, for their common general interest, which is certainly something broader than the interests of, shall we say, the Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, when they promote certain broad interests of the class as a whole, where various factors operate, not merely the fluctuations in the stock market, they are obliged to take certain measures which sometimes even evidently and manifestly hit against what appears to be their immediate interest. But that should not delude us into thinking that the capitalist class in our country, or for that matter, that this government has adopted a policy of making the rich pay for the poor. That is not at all so, and the ₹1,600 crores or so, out of which only ₹1,000 crores would come from the direct taxes, should not make us think that there has been a radical change in this direction that we all desire. We welcome the halting step that the minister takes. We welcome the steps, however belated, and we welcome even the pickpocketing of the capitalists. It requires only a pickpocket to get ₹1,000 crores from the capitalist class. Even when they do such things, we always welcome them. Madam, I would like to say a few words. It was not my intention to speak on this bill at all, but having listened to the speech of the Honorable Minister towards the end of his reply, I am rather provoked, shall I say frankly, to say a word or two about the policy of the government in the matter. It is pointless for the government and the minister here to tell us that there has not been any shift in the policy with regard to foreign participation and the role of foreign enterprise in the oil industry of our country. Now, we do not have the time nor the opportunity just at the time to recall the various utterances and statements given solemnly on the floor of this house and in the other house by the then Honorable Minister Mr. Malviya and others of the government also enunciating certain basic approaches to questions of policy. What was it? In the first place, it was decided after a lot of groping in the dark in the earlier stages that as far as the oil industry was concerned, it should be from now on developed entirely in the public sector. So thanks for watching. Do like, subscribe and share.